Something closely related to prime numbers is the prime factorization of a number. The problem factorize asks for the prime factorization of a given positive integer x. Of course, factorize is not a decision problem. We actually want to find the prime factorization. However, we can formulate a decision version of that problem. Let's call it factor. The problem factor will be the following. The input is a number x and a second number y. And the question is whether x has a non-trivial factor that is smaller than y. Here, non-trivial just means not equal to 1, because of course 1 will be a factor of x. This decision problem factor is closely related to factorize, the problem of finding the prime factorization of an input number x. Specifically, we have self-reducibility here. So factorize reduces to a factor in polynomial time in the Cook sense. Meaning if we have an oracle for the decision problem factor, we can also solve factorize in polynomial time. This is not very difficult, we just need a simple trick. For a number x, we can find the smallest non-trivial factor in polynomial time if we have access to an oracle for the language factor. And we do this by using binary search. So we know that the number x has some factor between 1 and x. I mean, if nothing else, then x itself would be a factor, I suppose. And then we split this candidate interval, which in the beginning reaches from, 2 to x, in the middle. And we ask whether there's a factor of x that is in the first half of that interval. Or if not, then we know that the smallest factor must lie in the second half of the interval. And we keep doing this, and we can halve the size of the interval in each step, and therefore we will only need log x many such steps. So here's a pseudocode for this procedure. We start with the interval from 2 to x, and then as long as the interval contains more than one element, we look at the middle of that interval, and we are asking whether there's a factor of x that is smaller than this middle point of the interval. And if yes, then we adjust the right-hand side of the interval to make it smaller and set it equal to the middle. And otherwise, we adjust the left end of the interval and make it larger to be equal to the middle. And in the end, the interval will only contain a single element, and we will just return that element, which will be the smallest factor of x. So we can quickly find the smallest factor of a number x if we have access to this oracle for factor. To find the prime factorization of a number x, we find the smallest factor of the number first, and then we divide the number by that smallest factor, and then we just repeat the process with whatever remains. And we keep doing this until we factorize the entire number completely. And the important observation here is that the smallest factor of the number x will be a prime factor. And therefore, this process really leads to a prime factorization of our number. What is the running time for this? We said we can find the smallest factor in polynomial time if we have access to an oracle for factor. And also, we don't have to find too many smallest factors. This is because the smallest non-trivial factor of a number is always at least 2. So each time we find the smallest factor and then divide our number by that factor, the number will at least halve. And therefore, if we start with a number x, this can only happen log x many times. And so therefore, overall, we have polynomial running time, meaning running time that is polynomial in log x, which is the size of the binary encoding of the input number x. Finding the prime factorization of a number is a fundamental problem. And we have now established that instead of thinking about that problem, we might as well just think about the decision problem factor instead. This is because we have self-reducibility here. I claim that this problem factor is contained in NP and is also contained in CoNP. So it's contained in the intersection of NP and CoNP. To see this, we just observe that there are clearly succinct certificates for the factor problem. A succinct certificate that would certify that a number x has a non-trivial factor smaller than y would just be to give such a non-trivial factor. So we could provide a number z that is smaller than y but larger than 1. And a verifier could easily check that this number z indeed has the claimed properties. To have a succinct disqualifier for factor is a bit more complicated, but it's possible. As a succinct disqualifier, we can use the prime factorization of the number x. And then if none of the prime factors of x are smaller than y, the answer to our problem has to be no. There is no factor of x that is non-trivial and smaller than y. We know that all the prime factors are larger than y. The trick here is that we also have to somehow prove to a verifier that what we provided is indeed the prime factorization of x. So we would have to somehow certify that all the numbers in this factorization are indeed prime. But we have previously seen that this is possible using slightly more sophisticated certificates. So for each of the numbers here in this factorization, we would also include a certificate that those numbers are prime. So overall, we have succinct certificates for factor and we have succinct disqualifiers for factor, and therefore factor is in the intersection of NP and CoNP.